this hash. You can't go yet.
Why not?
Because you can't take it. No, there it is.
Mammy, I'm too old to still take that old lady, Tommy.
No, you ain't. I know best. I've been giving you a spoonful of my very own special yolkum dairy tonic every day since the day you was born. And I intend to give you a spoonful of it every day until the day you die. And for 7 weeks thereafter. Now, open and hold.
But Mammy...
Open and hold.
But maybe if she catches me, I got to marry her.
What could be sweeter than that?
Boy, don't feel he's ready
yet. Why don't you mosey into town?
But
go on. You was going down the lower Lake District.
But I prefer to stay.
Trouble. Turn it into a round.
Why would you let me
born? Old man, corn, corn, corn.
and my beloved constituents of Dalton. I could stand here and bask in the sunshine of your warm, green forest.
That's good in on town, Fogbell.
Yeah, get to the point.
Why? Senator, tell them what you've done for us down there in Washington.
I done got the United States Senate to pass the Jack S. Fogbell bill. Gonna be world famous.
And just what though is we gonna be world famous for? What though?
You is gonna save the lifeblood of a vigorous, thriving American industry. That's what though.
Which industry's that, Senator?
My boy, a glorious young industry devoted solely to the stimulation and relaxation so necessary to the American business. An industry known as Las Vegas.
Las Vegas?
Ain't that where they do all that gambling?
Yes, sir. Mammy Yoko. And right there's the problem. You see, in a desert nearby, the governments are shooting off certain nuclear weapons of war.
Atom bombs!
That's right. And the atomic dust from these bombs is floating down and settling in the Las Vegas swimming pools and on the beautiful green felt crap shooting tables.
Oh!
I tell you, his eyes are turning black hot in them spots, but you can't hardly tell whether you got snake eyes or box cars.
No!
Is it going on them slot machines?
Oh, no!
Oh, yes, there is. And when you hit the jackpot, you don't dare touch your money, because it might be radioactive.
That whole industry!
Because you think your government, up there in Washington, is going to stand by and let this happen to an American industry?
No!
No, my good friend. And that is why the Jack S. Fogbell Committee has been chosen.
To find a new place to test them bombs?
Yes, sir. Someplace we can blow off the face of the earth. Someplace they never gonna be missed. In fact, the most unnecessary place in the whole USA.
Well, I'll be darned.
And I now, as the honor and privilege of announcing that of all the no good, no account, unnecessary places in this whole country, you have been chosen as the most unnecessary of all. United States government. Yeah. The fine governmental scientist who's going to supervise your evacuation, Dr. Regalia T. Finsdale.
When Satan can remove you from those patch to a necessary place in our society, the first destination will be on Wednesday. But the evacuation will stop immediately. Good luck. And thank you.
And so, dear constituents, as I bid you farewell,
I beg you, don't let me down.
Remember, your government spent $1 billion on one bomb to blow your homes off the face of the earth. So show your appreciation.
Hooray! Yippee!
Yahoo!
Just
hurry.
lady. They's dropping the bomb on Wednesday. Sadie Hawkins Day ain't till Friday. So there can't be no more Sadie Hawkins Day. Approval of her next of kin. Right, Randolph me?
Right.
Therefore, I claim the aforementioned, ever popular Miss Daisy May.
Well now, is there any of the claimers? Well, if there ain't any of the claimers, we just got out of the gate.
I also claim the ever popular Lady in Wish.
You just won!
I claim Daisy.
The ever sensible Romeo Scrag.
Romeo Scrag? He's a no good barber, and I object.
And I object too, Kesha.
I know the objection for this family.
I'm just as objectionable as you.
You're both objectionable. Daisy, is Romeo Scrag your Kimbo boy?
Well, yes, but it's the size of the family.
Once a Scrag, always a Scrag.
Is it true that you gave Daisy May earthquake goo?
Correct.
How could you make such a miserable decision?
Because earthquake is not a man.
A good man. A man who put love in his heart, rage in his country, and just put $4 in my side pocket. Bless you, my children.
Well, let me
easy. We gotta help find something necessary or a whole town.
Why did you do it?
I don't know, Daisy. I just did it, that's all.
But why?
Well, there you were, your sweet and usual self. And there was no earthquake looking at you like a hound dog on the first day of hunting season. And I ain't gonna let no one look at you like a hound dog. Especially not a hound dog like a dude. So I just ups and ducks, that's all.
Does this mean you aim to let me catch you if we have Sadie Hawkins Day?
Reckon so.
Oh, Abner, what took you so long?
I don't know, Daisy. Some years I wanted to awful bad, but I just couldn't. I don't know why I couldn't, but I couldn't.
There must have been a reason.
Take last year's race. There I was, loping along with my usual burst of brilliant speed, when I looked around and seen you, sweet and pretty, reaching out your hands to grab me for life. And all of a sudden, a little voice inside of me hollered, Abner boy, take off. And I took.
That's all behind us now.
You really reckon?
And life's gonna be full of so many wonderful things. Things you and I've been deserving for such a long, long time.
Namely what?
Special dog pants edition.
But that's no printing it. The paint's wrong.
put these on.
Deadly weapons guaranteed to stupefy any human male dead in his tracks. Here, I'll demonstrate. Hey, give me my gravity. Come on over here. Stupefy. Unstupefied.
What you want?
Oh, nothing. Well, leave immediately.
Thank you.
place in the dog patch. However, this dog will need exhaustive tests on human beings. Are there any volunteers?
You got one of them right here. He's gonna come out looking anything like Abner. You got yourself one guinea pig. That stuff will make something like that out of something like this. You got him.
Take mine too. I'll be satisfied if I had a pair of shoulders like that.
I'll be happy if mine had one shoulder like that.
Gentlemen, you'll find the talk meeting just down the road.
Ma'am, does this mean we're gonna be necessary after all?
My dear young lady, if these tests fulfill their promise, dog patch will not only become necessary, it will become absolutely indispensable!
My dear General Bowles.
Oh, don't you dare
Major General Bowman's meat, you bumbling, incompetent, hillbilly cretin? Do you have any idea what you've done? Why, if I own this drug, I can make all the money in the world. And I need it. Ever since I was a child, I had a dream. It was a simple child's dream. And all that simple child wanted was to get his hands on all the money in the world. And you imbecile, you shattered a little child's dream. No, I'm not taking those pill pills anymore. They make me think too positive.
Mr. Yoakum, here, sir.
Well, send them in. If that's not a state, I may need you. Well, don't just stand there. Show them in. My boy, my dear boy, I'm General Bolmustein.
Howdy, General.
And you know the senator? And this is Miss Appassionata von Climax, my... confidential secretary.
Confidential secretary?
Yeah, you can read all about me in confidential.
Howdy, ma'am.
How do you do, Mr. Yoakum?
Mighty pretty. Pardon, ma'am. Did you shoot it?
No, I kind of trapped it.
So pretty. When does the season open up on that stuff?
He never closes.
Yoakum, my boy, I think it's time you and I talked a little business. Now, I'm offering you $1 million in cash for the manufacturing rights to your drug.
But I already told the president.
President? What president?
The president of the United States.
Oh, that president. Forget that, my boy. I don't think you comprehend what this elixir of yours can do.
It'll save Vermont and my hometown. That's all I care about.
Idealistic nonsense. Yoakum, so far the tests show that this drug of yours exceeds the most fantastic discoveries of science.
Is that good?
Good. Why, it'll give every male a part of the physique. It'll make fat men thin and thin men fat. It'll broaden your shoulders and it'll narrow your hips. It'll toughen your skin and it'll soften your beard. It'll clean your teeth and whatever illegal leave your breath all alone.
So got good manners, don't it?
Do them. Say the word and we're ready to go into production. We'll bottle it. We'll name it after you. We'll call it Yoka-Cola.
Yoka-Cola,
son. We'll make billions. And for a starter, here's my check for $1 million.
Thanks, General. But if you don't mind, it's 100% red-blooded American. I reckon I just did give it to the government. Now, if you'll excuse me, they're running Sadie Hawkins Day tomorrow, and I don't want to miss it. Bye, General. Bye, Miss Confidential.
You can't give away $1 billion. Believe me, my boy, it just isn't thrifty.
I know, General, but I've always been kind of sporty with money. Bye, y'all.
Well, I'm not through. Not yet. Now, Bogdan, what's this Eddie Hawkins name?
Oh, it's a dog patch custom where all the gals chase the men and marry whomsoever they catches.
Can an outsider enter?
Sure can.
Aha, we've got it. We've got a dog patch. A passionata enters the ring. She catches Abner Yoakum. She marries Abner Yoakum. And by community property, she owns half of everything he owns, especially Yoakumberry Tonic. Then, if some accident should befall the poor fool, you, his young widow, will be the sole possessor of the entire drug.
But Baldy, what happens if I don't catch him? I never run anymore.
You'll run at this time, or you'll be back at Howard Johnson's. Bogdan, can you make sure she catches him on Sadie Hawkins Day?
General, I know he's just the man for the job.
Well, in fact, you're bad to passionata, we're heading for the hills. All I'll tell you, we'll show these hillbillies what's what. Right, girls?
Right. He makes the rules and he intends to keep it that way. What's good for General Bowman is good for the USA.
Thank you.
That is if he wants.
Don't worry. He'll want.
Thank you.
14. Q? No, Ed.
That's pretty narrow. But it's available.
Where's Daisy? Why didn't you come and meet me?
Maybe she don't want no party, son.
Then again, maybe she does.
Hi, Daisy.
Hi, Abner.
I sure missed you, Daisy.
Sure missed you too, Abner.
So glad I got back in time for the race this afternoon.
Sure, you still want to go through with it?
Sure, I'm sure.
Have you figured out how I'm going to catch you? So we both know what we're doing.
Well, not exactly.
I have. Just close your eyes and see if you can visualize it. Now you take off with your usual burst of brilliant speed.
Naturally.
I hightailed it right after you.
I seize it.
You head out for Repulsive Rock.
I gotcha.
I take the shortcut over Hog Fat Boulevard.
I might see it.
You see me coming and ducks off from Stabilly Lane.
I'm ducking.
I'm gaining on you and we's headed for the promised land.
This screech gulch.
Right.
I seize you now. As my feet start slippery and those goose feathers, you start gaining. You's only a couple feet behind me.
Couple feet.
You got your hand.
I reach it.
Your fingers spread and grab me.
I'm grabbing.
And bend.
Yes.
I'm sorry, Daisy.
What happened?
I put on a burst of brilliant speed and dashes out of sight.
You mean you still ain't gonna let me catch you?
Well, I don't know. I sure intended to, but now I just don't know.
I'm a yokum.
But I know this much, Daisy. I'm going to get in the race this afternoon and do my darndest to let you catch me. And no matter what happens, I wish you the best of luck. Because if anybody deserves me, you do.
Fellow, he's the same color as money. All right, you
tussling on the Abner-Yoke miracle drug continues behind a cloak of top secret echelon securities.
everybody who feels. I misses them too.
It's a special uncle today, Sam. I got this cold, shuddery feeling, and I just know L'il Abner's in real mortal danger.
What makes you so sure?
I always get this terrible feeling when he's in trouble. It's a clutch and grabbing feeling right in here. Know what I mean?
Of course I do, honey. Every time I get that feeling, it's either a mite of gas, the approach from a crater, or I've got the wrong button on my drawers.
Oh, I'm so miserable, Sam.
Look, if you feel L'il Abner's really in more trouble, why don't you go to Mary and have her conjure up one of her visions? See if he's all right.
I did, and she's inside conjuring one up right now. But I don't know whether she can conjure all the way to Washington.
Oh, don't you worry about men.
But I sure wish she'd hurry.
I can hardly wait to get there.
I wonder what they look like.
Hi, baby.
Hi, Sam.
Hey, where are you going?
We've been to Washington to pick up our newly beautified husband.
Yeah, the government sent for us.
Say, what you got in there?
We got these from Available Joe.
It's his special happiness guaranteed on your second honeymoon. Do it yourself, kid.
Will you be seeing L'il Abner when you're up there?
We'll look him up.
Be sure to tell him that I hope he'll be happy.
Sure, we'll tell him, Daisy. Come on, we best get to the station and pick up our tickets.
Bye, Daisy.
They all so happy I could almost cry.
Now. Everything's gonna be just fine.
How can it be? I'll just never get married.
What makes you say that for?
Who'd want me now? I've waited so long, I'm so wasted away.
Well, and now that may be, but what you've got left over is more than what most folks start out with.
No, Sam. I looked in the mirror this morning, and there's no doubt about it. My good years are gone.
Well, I guess you're right. After all, you is pushing 18.
I'm past my prime.
What a shame.
And I'm losing time.
Get the old clocks run down.
17 last
May. My old wasted life.
Still without a ring.
Oh, my wife.
I'm past my peak.
It's an early antique.
Look at this fatigue.
Just me and the old bones to reach.
Where the words have blown.
And
all the wrinkles show.
And now Romeo.
Think of marrying it or don't you marry it.
Yeah.
tuned into the right channel?
I told you, Lana always does. I tell you, they're gonna kill you, Lana. That's what we gotta do something.
And we've gotta act fast.
We gotta get the washing done.
Daisy, I desire words with you.
Hey, Shelton, please.
But I love you, gal.
Not now. He's in terrible trouble.
Marry me. I'll do anything for you.
Hey, we ever gonna defeat a strong force like General Bulu?
Name somebody you don't like. You will.
David!
Well, you say it on one condition.
What's that?
That you comes up to Washington and uses your brute strength to help save little Abner's life.
If I does, you solemn promises to give yourself to me.
I solemn promises to give myself to you.
Body and soul?
Body and soul.
One at a time or both together?
You take your pick.
Maybe you just got yourself a passport to ecstasy.
Not now. Time.
We've got to need help. You get those ordinary scraps and anyone else that can scrap and tell them to bring their socializing clothes. We've headed for high society country.
Right.
make no difference to him. You know he died for us, for he breaks his promise.
Oh, Daisy, child!
There's only one way to convince him. I'll just have to use my feminine wiles.
Feminine wiles!
Daisy, what are you doing here?
Oh, I don't know. I just had to see you once more.
Gosh, Daisy, sure sight for sore eyes.
Am I, Abner?
Sure is.
I comes up here because since I knows you so well, I thought I might be able to give your intended some advice.
Advice?
About some of the things that makes you happy.
Sure sweet of you, Daisy.
Like your breakfast. How much cream and sugar you like on your cold poke chop?
Miss Appassionata ain't the cold poke chop type.
And how to dig your special worms and bait your hook. But most of all, how to fix your home so that it'd be a nice loving home. Like the one you and I might have had. Remember that piece of land you always liked?
Smack between poison oak gulch and contagious land.
Nice view of the skunk worm.
Walking distance from a necessary mountain.
Oh, we'd have had a sweet little home, you and I. Just close your eyes and picture it.
I can see a rocking chair, a lamp, a couch, and...
And love, Abner. Don't forget love. You can...
Bye.
and if you don't let them in, she's going straight to Marvin Zindler.
Marvin Zindler? I can't afford an incident tonight. Not tonight, only up until midnight to get that formula. All right, let them in.
Sir?
Well, clean them up. Make them presentable. Take them to the West Wing.
Yes, sir.
No. Take them to the East Wing. The wind is from the west.
Yes, sir.
You, go keep an eye on Yoakum. Make sure he doesn't know they're here.
Right.
All right, you, go call the police. Tell them I want a squad of men discreetly placed around the ground.
Yes, sir.
General, you're not really letting those miserable hillbillies into your home.
My boy, there's no limit to what you have to do today to get your hands on a measly couple of $1 million.
What if they should be seen? Think of your dignity.
Dizzy. A thing of the past. What? With all these new mangled progressive ideas? The Social Security? The old age pension? The filtered cigarettes? I told them, I said, you put a radical like Ronald Reagan in the White House, and they call it progress.
Yeah.
that you aim to hurt our good friend Abner, who we love and adore.
Preposterous!
But he's wrong, and so we'll go. And quietly.
Double-crossing son of a pig in the trap!
Earthquake, you're the gentleman!
Thank you, Abner. But I'd so like us all to part friends, so I'm asking you, Brother Full Moose, to let us all join you in a toast to Abner. And the future, Mrs. Yoker.
Why, you know who miserable...
Well, I'm not one to harbor a grudge. Waiter, champagne.
Well, I told you he was a friendly like. To the bride-to-be. May the flower of her innocence burst into blossom and bring joy to this fine young man.
There you is, a ricochet truth wearer by Mr. Full Moon.
Earthquake, you little rat, we got
him! And he's got to tell the truth.
Mr. Policeman, just you listen. General Full Moon, is you or is you not a no good double crossing thief and crook?
Would you repeat the question?
Is you or is you not a no good fanatical double crossing crook?
Yes, madam, I am.
Yes, yes. What did you intend doing with Abner Yoker?
Subject him to evil eye. Truth, whammy.
So he tell you?
The secret formula of Yoka Mary Tonic.
Whereupon you intended to?
Further use the nefarious E.E. Fleagle.
The purpose being?
To put a suicidal whammy on the gullible Yokum.
Whereupon the poor fool would?
Jump into my fastest sports car.
And subsequently?
Drive himself over the nearest cliff.
Make him appear alive.
Accidental death.
What for real and true it was?
Cold-blooded, premeditated murder.
There you have it.
The best murderer, take him away. Attention, everyone. All residents of Dogpatch are hereby ordered to return to their homes immediately and resume their orderly evacuation.
Evacuation?
Are you crazy?
I'm Mrs. Power.
Yes. There are buses outside to transport you back to Dogpatch.
But what about our Yoke and Mary Tonic?
The tests have been declared a failure.
Oh. A failure?
Now attention, all pilots. A special bus will take you to the landing point immediately. Mr. Yoakum, you'll have to come along with them.
We're not go!
Step lively, everyone. This way, Mr. Yoakum. Come along, ladies.
Wait a minute. Now I heard you fair and square. You was coming with me.
Please don't speak none until I find out what's going to happen to Abner, please.
But remember, use mine now, forever and forever.
Yes, Earthquake. I'm yours.
I'm sure. I mean, I told the truth.
drinking yokenberry tonic all my life.
Was that silly tool, Mr. Yoken?
Oh, that's no good, miserable tree!
Jimmy, these men and Mr. Yoken for further study.
Well, Daisy, I guess this is goodbye for a while.
Goodbye forever.
Forever? Why?
I promised Earthquake that if he'd come up here and help save your life, that me and him would get married. So he's gonna.
Earthquake, can I have one moment alone with Daisy before you leave?
Well.
Please, Earthquake.
No messing around.
No messing around.
I know how it feels, Daisy. You gotta go through with it. A promise is a promise.
Maybe there's something we can do.
It's too late now. Don't you worry, none. Earthquake's bound to be a fine man. Once he's married up with you.
It ain't never gonna be like it could be with you.
Please, Daisy.
I was there. Dearly beloved,
are you out of your mind? It's anything but run their way. No, Fenton, you completely evacuated it towards you, Fenton.
All right, all right. Come on, you heard the lady, Sam. Get
that's right,
up.
Sam. Proceed. Only I do wish you wait, earthquake dear, till all my kinfolk get here, on account of this wedding's gonna mean so much to them.
Why, of course, my dear.
Since the bombing and all, they's all gonna move in with such a nice new home.
Why, of course, my dear.
With their new rich relative.
Most assuredly, my pet. Rich relative? Who?
Why, you, of course.
Me?
You don't think a scribe would let another scribe go homeless? As long as they was related to anyone as well-heeled as the world's dirtiest rascal.
You mean you want this miserable scrag to come and live with us?
Naturally. Others will be along directly.
Well, Daisy and others?
I knew you'd want it that way, Earthy dear.
Well, I...
Ah, Daisy! Why, it's Uncle and Sociable Scrag and his three fine children. Unthinkable, unwashable, and unbearable.
Look who came out of the swamp. An appetizing scrag.
Howdy, Daisy. Howdy, Daisy.
Well, upon my soul, if it isn't the Scarsdale scrag.
Well, Sam, ain't you got some merry to
do? I sure have. We're all fastened on the hats and hangs on to each other. Why, let's fly my $8 wedding.
Just some plain creek water.
to face it, you can't move it, and you can't bomb it.
You're absolutely right. Stop that plane and notify Washington. The evacuation is ended.
Until we pay his homage, it's the one man who made this all possible. Who saved our town from being bombed? None other than that beloved man sitting up there in that hose. Jubilation, T. Cardi Pole.